I am Tom Sturridge, but you may know me as Dream of the Endless, or, the Sandman.
And I'm Gwendoline Christie, and I play the most badass, best, and absolute coolest version of Lucifer on Netflix.
How would you describe the dynamic between Lucifer and Dream?
I think that there is a deep underlying respect between them. A respect that I would even go so far as to say affection. The two people who are in not dissimilar positions of power. The ruler of hell. The king of the dreaming. I think despite this being a moment of conflict, there is an underlying simmer of connection.
You see, I got nothing.
From me?
Yep.
Intentional.
As the challenged, I set the meter. The wings are taking up a lot of space, aren't they?
A lot of space, yeah.
The wings are doing a lot.
No, they're definitely telling me you're not human.
You know, when we did this scene, I thought you hated me.
Oh, why that choice?
You didn't give me a lot. You know, I thought he doesn't like me, he doesn't want me doing this, he wants someone else doing this. But you know, I fought my way through.
Did you have any input into the hair? Was that your hair, for example?
It was your hair.
It was my hair.
It had been gathered
from a
series of haircuts that you've had over the last 12 years. It's something, because this project, there's been so many suggested ideas for the Sandman to come to the screen. So very early on, I put in the request that whenever you had your haircut, it be saved for Lucifer's wig. I am a serpent. Horse biting.
I am a bird of prey. Snake devouring. Talons ripping.
Oh, look.
Oh, God.
Upsetting. You don't look sorry.
I don't. Really.
I do.
I know.
All that foundation ruined. Oh, my God. Yours is perfect.
I can see my reflection in your costume.
Can you? It's wiped clean, the costume. I was told it had to be if I was working with you.
Oh my gosh, what does it look like I'm doing then?
Destroy.
Ode of constipation.
Yep. That, you were constipated. That fall was real.
It's
because
that
you needed to go to the bathroom so badly. You broke out in that rash. And I was pleased.
A world. Space floating. Life.
Into the countryside.
A field outside Bristol.
It was. And all that fresh air is aggravating me. So much so that those wings are going. Yep. Climate change.
Yep. Very top on
Look
top
at
there.
Me. I seem to like the high temperatures. This is very powerful.
This is actually the darker. This is very powerful. Suddenly, not seeing anything, I feel everything.
I enjoyed it though. You know that Jamie put on that lighting state and it did something
sexy state.
Weird.
Yeah.
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 You had to be contained.
I did. It was, yeah.
There's a lot of mopping around you.
Yeah. Wow. I got sweaty.
There actually was to keep the floor clean.
It's true. Every time someone steps, people were wearing slippers.
And so that was you after that big night out.
Boss. Yeah.
Hey. Boss.
A raven, which was there, real raven.
Yeah, it was real raven. Your Majesty. It's a very, very good costume, very realistic raven. I heard you got into a relationship with a raven after filming, during filming,
friendship.
Which is problematic.
Friendship. He was also a fan of Tolstoy.
is this you with no makeup on?
Yes.
I thought so. I'm really examining your face there because you have excellent bone structure.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm assessing it and seeing that your face is very symmetrical.
It's so lucky.
And I'm furious. I'm furious about your complexion there. That's what I was thinking when I was saying the lines. How angry I was at how great your skin is. That's why I look so perplexed.
Listen, what do they say about Marlene Dietrich? Seriously, what did they say about my Dietrich?
Many things that perhaps might not be appropriate and seen. Okay. It certainly wasn't a challenge to bring the real world experience to the scene, because the second that we started shooting the very first scene, Tom was clearly so invested in Dream in a very real, emotional way.
I was apprehensive before this scene because it is huge in its concept. You are in the castle of Lucifer, the ruler of hell, and you are there because he has something of yours. You try to put those ideas in your head, you get a bit lost. But when I walked into that room and Gwendoline was standing there, everything made complete sense and I knew exactly how I should feel, and all we did was talk to each other.
It was a real pleasure, mostly.
Ditto.
Be sure to watch The Sandman, now streaming on Netflix.
See you in hell.